Hi friends, welcome to our channel Pragya Bhumi. Today, here in this video, we'll discuss about the topic Freedom Movement in India Phase 1. In this video, particularly, we'll discuss about the factors leading to the rise of Indian National Movement and about the formation of Indian National Congress. Post this, like after the Congress formed from 1885 till 1919, what happened, I'll be posting in the next video. Once it's posted, I'll mention the link in the description below. Come on friends, let's get into the video. So, starting about the factors leading to the rise of Indian National Movement. As we can see, in the second half of the 19th century, Indian people were becoming more politically conscious and somehow they wanted freedom for their country. So, there were many factors that led to the rise of Indian National Movement. Here, I have mentioned about 7 factors. We will see one by one. The first factor is British imperialism. That is, once the British people started dominating India, the Indian people got unified because of that. And the second factor is European countries' contact. Once the Indian people started coming in contact with many European people, they got modern ideas of liberty, human rights and democracy. And also, at that time, they came to know about unification of Germany and Italy. That is, the Italy was broken into 3 empires like North, Center and South. And finally, after a great fight, those 3 empires joined and emerged into Italy. So, these all thoughts provoked the thoughts of Indian people. And third is about the modern methods of transport and communication. This connected people from every nook and corner of the country. So, they were able to tell like whatever they felt and whatever they wanted to do. And fourth is about the great leaders. Great leaders like Tilak, Nehru, Gandhi and many more. And even social reformers like Rajaram Mohan Roy and Vivekananda, they all like spreaded ideas of national awakening ideas. So, these all leaders stayed as inspirations for Indian people, making them all to stand against the British rule. Coming to the fifth point, Indian press and literature. This was a backbone of Indian people, like the whatever they wanted to express, they expressed this through press and literature. So, newspapers like Kesari, Maratha and writings of Tagore, Bharati, Bankim Chandra Chatterjee all inspired people and brought patriotic feeling among the Indian people. But unfortunately, at that point, Vernacular Press Act of 1878, this is very important friends, Vernacular Press Act of 1878 was passed. This is to limit the freedom of press. That is, after this, the Indian people cannot like publish anything through press or literature. So, this created like more agitation and unrest among the Indian people. And sixth is a very, very important thing that led to the rise of Indian National Movement. That is the 1857 revolt. This is quite a big topic. So, I have discussed this in my another video, which is in my channel. You can go and check it out. So, this was the starting point and this led to the freedom which we got in 1947. And talking about the last factor is divide and rule. This was the policy that British people used. Here, what happened was racial discrimination followed. That is, Indians were not preserved for any higher post. So, Indians got like totally annoyed. And one more thing what happened was Ilbert Bill. This bill was passed by Lord Ripon. What it promised was to give higher posts for Indians. But like controversy to that, Indians did not get higher posts. So definitely the Indian people got so much annoyed and they also came to know that they cannot expect fair justice from British people. So all these factors clubbed together rise of Indian National Movement. Next we'll see about the formation of Indian National Congress. Indian National Congress formed due to many reasons. One thing is like, since most of the Indian people got in contact with Europeans, they had the modern ideas of liberty, human rights, democracy, all those things. So they did not want to be under anyone's rule. And also British people promised to give few things which they failed to do. Like starting about the Charter Act of 1833 and 1853, where the British people promised to give higher posts to Indians, they did not do it. And also about the policy of discrimination, which I mentioned in the divide and rule policy. This also like mentioned that no higher posts for Indians. And also the Indian people were becoming day by day politically conscious, and the national feelings of inside them was increasing. Two important acts of 1878, the Arms Act, which said that an Indian soldier carrying a gun or an armed item has to possess a license, otherwise it is a criminal affair. But that was not in the case of Europeans. And also about the Vernacular Press Act. Like in India, newspaper was the strongest media of communication. But once this act was passed, the freedom of press got curbed and the newspapers did not connect much people. So this was totally very dissatisfaction among the Indians. And also about the failure of Ilbert Bill of 1883, which also promised to give higher posts for Indians, but it did not do so. So these all reasons clubbed together along with the political consciousness which the Indians possessed, mainly the educated Indians like lawyers, government employees, journalists, all those people they had, they did not want freedom, but they wanted a common platform to influence policy making. That is, they wanted a place in legislative councils or in the British rule. They wanted a place so that they can know what is really happening. And this led to the formation of Indian National Congress. Indian National Congress was started by the efforts of Alan Octavian Hume in 1885. So this was the starting point of Indian National Congress. The first session of this Congress was held at Bombay. It was headed by Umesh Chandra Banerjee with 72 delegates all over from India, including the Dadabhai Naurajji, Surendranath Banerjee, Madan Mohan Malaviya and many more leaders. So this was the first session which happened. The Indian National Congress had like many objectives to be achieved. First thing is place in legislative council. As I already mentioned, they wanted to know like what is happening in the country. So they wanted their place in the legislative council and more facilities for the spread of education. That is, they wanted to reach the masses of people all over India. So more facilities should be made in terms of education. And third is freedom of press. The freedom of press should be granted to the Indians so that they can reach more masses of people. The fourth thing is Indian civil service examination should be conducted in India. And even the Indian National Congress demanded low taxation and the military expenditure should be reduced. And as the British people promised to give Indians the higher post, the objective of the Indian National Congress also remained the same as the British people already mentioned to do. And also the Indian National Congress demanded to abolish the Indian Council that was existing at London. Here it's about a very important thing. The Indian National Congress as a group, it had two clusters of people like moderates and extremists. These were like two different clusters under the Indian National Congress. So starting with the moderates, moderates were educated middle class people. Whereas the extremists on the other side, they were the part of Indian National Congress, but they had lost faith in the methods of Congress. Like whatever the Congress was doing, the methods it adopted, these people lost faith and they wanted to deal the process in a very different way. The moderates wanted changes only in the constitution. Like they wanted a separate place for them. They wanted to change the policies, all those things. But these extremists, they demanded complete independence. So you can see that the moderates demanded constitutional agitation just in the policy making. But these extremists demanded political agitation. Since they wanted to achieve complete freedom for India, it was a political agitation. The moderates just they wanted to change the policy. They used a peaceful approach through petitions and requests. It was a very calm and very peaceful approach they wanted to maintain. But whereas the extremists, they had a very determined approach. They wanted to have a complete independence. And so they had like radical ideas on how to obtain those, the freedom they wanted. Since the moderates adopted peaceful approach, they were always very loyal and true to the British government. But on the other hand, extremists, they demanded freedom, right? So they did not want to depend on the mercy of the British government. So this was the main thing. The extremists rose ferociously against the British government. Few important leaders who were the moderates are Dadabhai Nauroji, Gokhale, Surendranath Banerjee. The extremists, it's like shortly called as Bal Pal Lal, that is Bala Gangadhar Tilak, Bipin Chandra Pal, Lala Lajpat Ghosh. So these were the set of people who were like extremists. So basically, moderates, they wanted to have a change in reforms. They wanted to have a place in the British Council. They wanted to know what is happening, and they targeted only in the upper sections of the society just to bring in a change. But the extremists, they wanted to spread their ideas to the masses so that they can achieve freedom very easily. This extremist, they initiated the national feelings among the people of India in a very, very, very important, in a very elaborated manner. So this is the difference between moderates and extremists. A small recap about what we saw is the factors leading to the rise of Indian National Movement, the seven things we discussed, and about the formation of Indian National Congress, why it got formed and when it was formed in the year 1885, who formed and how was the first session held, and also about the objectives of the Indian National Congress and the two classes of group inside the Indian National Congress, moderates, what they demanded, and the extremists, what they demanded. So this is about the formation of Indian National Congress, and about what happened in the coming years will be shared in my next video. Enjoy the video, give a thumbs up. For any doubts or suggestions, comment below. Finding it useful? Share it with your friends. For further videos, subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon. Bye! Thanks for watching. Have a good day!